Hey Potters, welcome to episode 204 of Cosplay the Podcast for all things cosplay. Hail and welcome.
Hail.
I may have heard one too many North Texas Irish Festival commercials.
I see no hail. What hail you speak of?
It's the kind of hail where you raise a glass and you say sláinte.
Oh, okay.
Not hail from the... No, please no.
It is Texas.
My car is still shiny. No.
It is Texas. It's bound to happen just randomly.
We still have 2 more months until severe weather season. Thank you very much. I will take my 29 degrees and I will like it.
It's Texas.
But anyways, welcome, welcome, welcome. If this is your first time with us here on Cospod, where have you been all of our...
9 years.
Long lives?
And all of our 9 years.
Yes, where have you been this past near decade of our podcast? But we are so glad to have everybody here, both new and old audience members alike. Thank you so much for being here and watching our complete zaniness.
Yay.
And we might just talk about a few things cosplay.
Usually we do. At least once per episode we talk something cosplay related.
So, oddly enough, part of my cosplay update is in the living room because I did not want it too near a heat source. So, I'm still doing some experimentation with attaching fabric to foam, especially because this is spandex to foam. And the mass number of adhesives I have, none of them are appropriate. I've tried multiple adhesives. None of them quite work. So I finally broke down because I remembered that I had seen a tutorial back in the day. I want to say it was one of Amethyst Angels for attaching fabric to foam. Mm-hmm. And they used 3M Super 77.
Mm-hmm.
I went and got a can. And it explicitly says, extremely flammable, do not leave near heat. Well, given that it has been 32 degrees here in Texas and my heater has been going off incessantly, I did not want to leave it near my crafting table, which is right underneath a heat vent. So I stuck it in my living room where I will be experimenting and praying because that is my last final hope. Super 77, you are my only hope. Please work to attach this spandex to this foam so that I don't have to sew it.
There are people gasping in chat right now that you don't have the right adhesive. Knowing it's you.
It's more that the adhesives I have are inappropriate for the task to which I am setting them, which is to attach a stretchable fabric to a non-stretchable medium and not have it wrinkle. Because typically you would want a flexible glue for this because spandex is flexible and so is the foam. But it will still wrinkle because there is too much flex being allowed in the fabric.
Right.
Compared to the foam. So it's finding that the correct surface tensile strength,
mm-hmm.
to go all scientific on you guys who are all gasping at me in chat. This is science. I will conduct science for the sake of making a costume
that
I don't really want to sew.
That's usually what we do anyway. We test things for cosplay. That's how it goes.
Yes, there has been much of the testing. And speaking of which... I also did some testing for the first time with wood stain because I've never had the chance to work with this stuff. And how have I lived without it all my life? I love this stuff. This stuff is better than acrylic paint, man. It's so much richer in color.
Mm-hmm.
And it's mostly self-sealing, actually. I don't have to seal these with polyurethane if I don't want to. I will eventually seal them, of course, because Murphy and I are great friends. But... for the most part, it's almost like spray paint, just so much better of a color. And this will actually come in useful when you guys see my make foam look like wood tutorial here shortly, because you can actually use this stuff as long as you seal your foam first. So I worked on that, and what else did I do? I started taking apart some old costumes.
Great.
Because I want to reuse the fabric, and so I found some scraps and I made curtain tie backs. And I get to experience the wonders of working with fringe for the first time. That'll be fun. So I did that. And is a little bit too far for me to reach. I don't want to knock the canister of wood stain over because that would suck.
Oh, nice. Okay.
So I'm making an air plant out of all of my extra squares of fabric that are too small for me to actually use for anything else.
Mm-hmm.
Because remember, part of my goal this year, Potters, was to not hoard. I will be disposing of my spare fabric, my large storage space full of spare fabric that I don't really have enough of to make any garments with. So I'm trying to find creative ways besides like aprons and sewing machine covers to use up this fabric. So I was like, okay, well, I can make my crafting, my cosplay space look nice and greeny because I cannot grow plants to save my life.
With little Kanzashi air plants.
Yes, I'm making little Kanzashi air plants that I never have to water. And what's better is that I can also weave chainmail holders for them.
There you go.
So I can be a real nerd. I get to keep my nerd card, yo. Yes, that is what I have been doing for the last 2 weeks.
All right, then.
There's a couple projects I can't show, but that's the vast majority of what I have been working on, along with the tutorial pieces that I am to show you guys very shortly.
Well, cool stuff. At least one of us is doing something. I've just been working and had no desire to do anything costume related, so eh.
Yes, but the terrible thing is that my apartment is now a horrendous mess because I've had so many different projects going at once.
Duh. That's part of the progress.
my poor mother, you know, I love her. She's like, you know, you should only just work on one thing at a time.
Oh, that's not how it's we like, roll.
I have tried for years to limit myself to one project. And while I am waiting for that one project to do something, it can be set, it can be letting the adhesive stick, it can be
letting the paint dry.
Exactly. While something is doing something for which I must wait and cannot touch.
Yep. Do something else.
Yes, what are you going to do? But yes, you start another project.
You do something else. You're multitasking.
While that project is doing its thing, and you still can't touch the first one yet, hey, I have a little bit of space over here on the table.
Let's start project number 3.
So yes, my apartment is a terrible, terrible mess, and I need to clean it up again. Spring cleaning. But at least I'm getting rid of stuff, even if I am just putting it other places.
You're putting it other places, but it is being used, and I know eventually you will get it all done.
I will get it used up, and I will have 6 very nice air plants that make my apartment look more elegant.
Yeah.
And I've actually nearly completed my patio door screen.
See?
Which is also using up a bunch of cotton and some netting I didn't even know I had. So I will have a nice patio door screen as well for when the weather gets nice.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully by that point I will have, you know, made the appropriate sacrifices to the Super 77 deities so that it will make the spandex stick to my foam.
I'm sure it'll be fine. It's all good.
Because then I have to stick either foam, styrene, or more spandex on top of that.
That
doesn't
sound
pleasant. Because of course it's layered.
Of course it is. Of course it is.
This is how anime works, yo. Nothing is ever simple.
Or easy.
Unless, of course, you're counting the lack of seams, which makes it very simple for them to draw it, but not so simple for us to make it.
Nope. Cosplay!
Alright, so enough from me. Would you like to provide some AllCon updates?
Yeah, absolutely. So basically, it's just a reminder to everyone that AllCon is less than a month away, which doesn't sound like it should be the case, but it definitely is less than a month away, which is ridiculous. Our online sign-up is still open, so if you are even thinking about entering our cosplay contest, definitely recommend that you do it now while you still can, because we are going to cap it, just to make sure that we have plenty of time to run everybody through, and we get prejudging all nice and smooth and all that funness. And in case if there's any technical issues at the con, at least you don't have to worry, because hey, you already signed up. All good gravy stuff. And of course, we definitely want to thank TNT Cosplay Supply again for their generous donation and help us get some super cool, amazing Uber prizes. Because once I totaled everything up, like, we're giving away close to a grand this year, which is ridiculous on every scope possible.
A good portion of which is in cash.
Yeah. We have the Cricut bundle. We have foam bundles that we're giving away to all of our first place winners in each category. We have also the trophies, because we know Val loves trophies, so everybody has to get a trophy.
I do too.
Trophies are great. They're
trophies
awesome.
Or medals.
Yeah. Those are the best. And then, of course, we also have to make sure that we thank our judges this year, because we have Hoku Props, we have Miko Miko Cosplay, and returning for us again, Ubi Meow Bao Cosplay. So can't thank them enough for joining us again this year. Give us the cool judging team that we need, and it's going to be an awesome show. So please make sure to sign up. Check out our website, our Facebook page, our social media, any of our social media. Link is there. Can't miss it.
Yep, and all cons got information on their page as well, just in case for some reason you can't find it on our site.
Yeah, so it's less than a month away. It doesn't feel like it's less than a month.
I know. It's like 3 weeks away, actually.
Yeah, it's a little ridiculous. My brain can't wrap around it.
When it's like 1 week before the con, and
exactly.
Then you start running around like, you know, bugs,
mm-hmm.
then we're totally going to feel it, and you guys won't be able to reach us for a week.
That Cricut bundle, by the way, it's kind of heavy. I wasn't expecting it to be so heavy. It's kind of heavy. So that's... I have extra boxes to lug around this year. Lucky me.
It's okay. I have a little hand truck.
We're going to need it.
I know. It'll be just like going back to the days of Akon when I was a panelist.
Oh, man. 500 boxes later.
Five, drop zero.
Okay, the five boxes later.
It was only because I brought, you know, three boxes worth of panel equipment and then one box for each of the cosplays I was going to wear. And then if I was feeling ambitious that year, I would bring my microwave. Which weighed more than all the other boxes combined.
There you go.
But it was mostly because whenever I do demos, I brought my entire workshop with me.
Yeah, Amber is very ambitious as a panelist, in both a good way and a bad way. In a good way, it's because she brings everything with her, so she does...
Because I do live demos.
She does live demos, which is really great, and they're really informative. In a bad way, it's because she has to lug all that stuff around.
And then I have to pack it all, you know, to bring it back to the hotel room and then put it all away when I get home.
Exactly.
I like doing live demos because then people get to actually see the process and they get
right. It's a lot more work, but it's definitely much more beneficial in the long run.
Ah, the art of paneling. Speaking of which, if you guys are looking at doing panels for your favorite local convention, we've actually done a couple of shows on how to be a good panelist.
Just go to our YouTube channel and check out the playlist that is specifically about cosplay panels. You cannot miss it because the plethora is all there.
Yep.
I reorganized everything on our YouTube page last year, and I'm very happy with it, so...
Yep, if you guys are working on your cosplay for your next convention, feel free to just put us on in the background. Pick your favorite playlist and then just let it go. It's not just us talking, it's not just these two heads.
Most of the time.
We have plenty of other panels and filmed content in there for you guys to listen to so that you can get a wide variety of perspectives and topics and coverage on both cosplay and costuming. It's good stuff. It's 9 years worth of content.
I can't believe it's been 9 years. Good gravy.
Alrighty. And with that, it's time for a tutorial.
Yay.
No, I'm not going to be burning anything down for you today. Actually, I will be showing you guys how to make foam look like wood. Hope you guys enjoy. All right, guys. So I was recently inspired as I was cleaning up my apartment, because I promised myself I would do that this year. And I, of course, have my Layla's knives that I made a couple years ago. If you guys used to follow me on DeviantArt, I had posted them up there. And I carved the handles out of foam. That is not wood. That is foam. And it has a wonderful tactile grip to it, and it feels kind of LARPish, actually. It feels like squishy wood. But I wanted to show you guys how you can get that sort of effect. If I can put that back in there. There we go. With your favorite material, our favorite material, which is foam, of course. Well, duh. We don't have any other favorite materials. It's always foam. That's always the answer. So, the only materials you will need, which are actually incredibly straightforward, you will need paintbrushes. Note that I have one detail brush. The other one, you pick what kind of thick paintbrush you want. But for doing the details, you actually need a detail brush. Brand doesn't really matter. I just pick whatever's cheapest. You need two colors of paint, one lighter, one darker. Pick your favorite brand, does not matter. I'm not going to evangelize paint types. I happen to like Ceram Coat, but for this I actually used a Apple Barrel and I used Anita's Craft Paint. So, you know, you do you, whatever you happen to have on hand. So you have paint, you have paint brushes, you have sealant of choice. For this demonstration, I happen to use Mod Podge Matte, which I found out actually develops a skin and dries out over time, so just keep that in mind. You may wish to use Hexflex instead. And then, of course, everybody's favorite, foam! So, I did this in four steps just so that you guys can see the process. So, of course, you have your lovely piece of foam. The first thing you will want to do with foam is you will want to seal it with something. The reason for that is because foam is like a sponge. It will absorb paint unless you seal it, and it will take you many, 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 many more layers of paint if you do not seal it first. Also, something to note, which you may actually be able to see on here now, that I have bent it. You hear the cracking noise? Yes, that is because, and I just flung the foam far, far away from me. That's okay. With the foam, if you seal it with something that is not flexible, like Mod Podge, and the foam bends, it will crack your paint job. And you will probably actually lose some of your paint job as it flakes off. So, if you need your foam to be flexible, which I will grab, if you need it to be able to bend, like say for armor, you will probably want to use Hexflex, or you will want to use something that has a latex base in it so that whenever you bend it, the paint will flex with it. Otherwise, you're going to get this really nice marbled cracking effect. So if that's what you're going for, please, by all means, use Mod Podge and then bend the ever-living daylights out of your foam. So, first things first, seal it. After you've sealed it, initial coat of paint. This is your lighter color. This guy. You only realistically need maybe two coats. You want it solid enough just so that you don't see any of the foam color through the bottom. That's really all there is to it. And again, remember I sealed this with Mod Podge so that when I bend this, crack, I just lost. There are now cracks in my paint job. So there's this really nice crackled effect on this, which is not quite what I wanted. This would only work if you're going to have a flat foam piece. That also goes, bend it out. It also goes for if you bend it inwards too. EVA foam is very flexible. Acrylic paint is not. Once you have given it a base coat, then you get to draw your textured pattern on it. I did this with ballpoint pen, and Val's gonna laugh at me because I always do my patterning with ballpoint pens, but I did this so that you guys can see it. Because when you do it the way that I intend you to do it, you actually can't see it on camera very well. And that's kind of the point. You can see the patterns I drew on the foam. It's supposed to make it look like the veins of a piece of wood. Hopefully that is visible there. Now you see why I did it in ballpoint pen, because that way you can see it. If you look at an actual piece of lumber, you'll find that it has all these tiny little veins in it, but they're very faint and they're a little bit hard to see, which is kind of the effect that you want in the foam. So generally you won't want to do what I just did, which is with a ballpoint pen, because it's going to be very, very obvious. I'm actually going to get to the heat gun thing here in just a second, because there's actually a way to make this better than what I'm showing you right now. So realistically, when you draw these little patterns in the wood, you would be doing that with your detail brush and your darker color. But this is not black, which is why you wouldn't be able to see it as well on camera. You'll see it in person. You just won't see it when I show it to you, which is why I did ballpoint pen. So you will draw the little veins. Think of Bob Ross when you're doing it. There are no mistakes, only happy accidents as you sit here and draw wood-like patterns on your foam. And then the last thing that you do once that has dried is you take your wide brush again and you paint one more layer of the lighter paint over it. It does not completely obscure it. In fact, you want it to be a very thin coat, not so thin that it's watercolor-esque, just quick, very quick strokes. You can even take a paper towel and wipe off the excess, because the point is that you don't want it to look obvious. You want it to look very subtle. You can probably barely see the patterns on here as I'm showing it to you guys, and that's kind of the point. This is not sealed. This is just the paint and just the patterns. It looks much better in person. Now, the color that I chose, I'm approximating wood stain, like this guy. You can see I'm trying to get closer to a dark stained wood. You don't have to go dark. If you want to go light, like birch or even ash, you can do that. There's nothing wrong with it. Just for this particular one, I happen to choose a darker wood to try and emulate. Once you have done this, then you can seal it so that the paint is sealed. Not just the foam, but the paint as well, because acrylic paints, if you've never worked with them, are not very waterproof because they are water-based. So if you get water on your wonderfully painted piece, you're going to lose all of your paint job. It's just going to literally drip off onto the floor. Now, that is the basic way of doing this. If you want to make it even better, here's where the heat gun comes in. So what you would do with your finished and not sealed piece, so, you know, you've already gone through all the motions, you've drawn your little veins in with your detail brush and all that, but you haven't done the final seal yet. What you can do, you can either take an X-Acto knife or pen knife. And you actually very, very carefully cut the veins. But you don't cut them all the way through. You barely cut into the foam. Basically, what you're trying to do is to give it a little bit of texture. Because what you do is then you hit this with a heat gun. Not only does that seal the foam, but it also opens up those veins just a little bit more. And then you can take the dark color or stain and do a wash. And it will soak into those grooves. And then you wipe away the excess so that you really get that textured effect. And that can really enhance the textured appearance of your foam. And that's why it's so important that you don't cut all the way through, because otherwise you could just break your piece open. That's why I usually prefer an X-Acto knife over a utility knife, because you have so much more control. Granted, they're also a little bit sharper, so you have to make sure you don't have very much pressure. And then, of course, once that's done, then you would seal it just like you would normally. If you want to, you can use Mod Podge and your favorite brush and paint only in one direction. Just give it one or two really thin, quick coats. And when it dries, it will also give it a brushed texture. And that will help add to the sort of wood-like appearance for it. But basically, that is the long and short of it. I will say that if you want to use it in something like a handle like this, you need to carve it and assemble it first. Don't paint it and then carve into it, because then you just carve all the paint away. So make your shape first, then do the painting and finishing effects. It, just in case that was not clear for some reason. EVA foam is fantastic for making handles on things like staves and swords and all sorts of things like that, because all you have to do is you just take a little Dremel, you just Dremel a little ditch, in each piece where the tang of your blade would go, and then you stick them together, and then you clamp them. That's it. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. And then you can carve, and then you get to do your fancy paint job. That's it! Ta-da! You have foam that looks like wood. Yay! Or you can take the easy way out and use contact paper. All right. Hopefully that proved helpful for you guys to see. Of course, if you have any tips or tricks that you've learned with working with foam, we always welcome you guys to contribute and to share those with the rest of the community, which of course you can do by joining in our conversation on any of our social media here.
In the corner, Val doesn't have to make a title card. It's so great. I'm going to sing it like every single time you do that now, I swear. I think I've done it every episode so far.
Most of the recent ones, or at least this season, yes.
Yeah.
And also, don't forget to tell us your favorite Nicolas Cage movie. And if you don't get that reference, yes, please make sure that you watch the episode previous.
203.
The one prior to this one, yes. 203.
Watch 203 and the after session on YouTube, because that will explain everything that you need to know. There was a lot of question marks on our Twitter feed when I made that post.
Yes, it means you should watch more of our shows. Because when you watch our shows, not only do you understand the inside references, but you also understand the punny titles.
And the importance of Nick Cage movies.
There is that as well.
Tomato, tomato. It's fine.
And with that, we will wish everybody working on their AllCon costumes the best of luck. Please remember to enter our contest. We would love to see all of your smiling faces there. We do cap it at 50, so sign up ASAP.
Yes.
And for everyone else, we will wish you guys happy cosplaying. See you next time.